Data providers are versatile objects that use a declarative language to make it easier for us to load structures, including simple items and collection items. As we saw in a previous video, when we wanted to have a data provider load a collection of elements, what we did was create a variable based on a structured data type that was a collection. And then we dragged that variable to the data provider source. As a result, its output was automatically configured to load this data type. In this video, we will focus on the possibility of a data provider to return a collection of elements when the structured data is not a collection. The travel agency had requested a report containing a ranking of the countries with the most tourist attractions. This example involves creating a collection of countries where each element is of a structured data type that stores data of a single country. First off, we will create a structured data type called SDT country, with the items ID, name, and quantity, where we will store the country's number of tourist attractions. This data type is not marked as a collection, so it will only be capable of storing data about a single country. Next, in the procedure object that implements the ranking, we create a variable called countriesCollection of SDT country type and set it as a collection. To obtain the details of all countries and build the ranking, we create a data provider object called data provider countries. Then we drag SDT country to the data provider source. As we can see, a code that reflects the structure of SDT country has been automatically created. However, we haven't found any repetitive group because there isn't a key defined group nested into another. Therefore, this definition written in the source will only be able to load data about one country. But we want to load data from all countries. Luckily, the data provider solves this problem by building the collection. To this end, we open the data provider properties, and in the output group, we set the collection property to true. Note that when we dragged SDT country to the data provider source, the output property was automatically configured with the name of the SDT, which we know stores a single element. However, by setting the collection property to true, we're telling the data provider to return a collection of elements of SDT country type. Also, let's note that the collection name has been displayed and that a name has been automatically assigned to the collection. To complete this definition, we will type where we want this data provider to obtain the data, which in our case is the country table. So, on the right, we assign the country ID attribute to the ID. And then also country name to the name. Next, we assign a count formula to quantity to have it count the number of attractions in the country. And our data provider is now ready to be run. If we right-click on the data provider name tab and select View Navigation, we can see that GeneXus specifies the object and shows the navigation report. The report says that it will run the country table to obtain the country's data, which is what we wanted. Now let's go back to the country's ranking procedure and define everything necessary to load the contents of the collection variable, countriesCollection. First off, we add the countriesCollection variable to the source and assign the data provider countries. When the data provider is invoked, it'll run through all the records in the country table and return a collection where every element is of SDT country type. This collection will be stored in the collection variable, countriesCollection, that we've also defined as a collection of elements of the same type. Note that the syntax used to invoke the data provider has not changed. The variable that receives the data provider's result, instead of being based on an SDT that is already a collection, is based on a simple SDT, and the variable is set as a collection by selecting the checkbox. From here on, the example is identical to that of the video Loading Compound Data Types Using Data Providers. In sum, we have two ways to have a data provider return a collection of elements. By defining a structured data type of collection type and dragging it to the data provider source, it is automatically configured to return a collection of that type. Or, by defining a structured data type that is not a collection and setting the data provider properties to have it build the collection. In the following videos, we will see other ways to use the data provider object.